Welcome back to the show, everyone. Welcome to Tampa Bay Nightlife TV. With us today is Rus Anderson from the Rocket Man Show. Hello. Rus, how you doing?
All right, man. Thanks very much for having me.
Thanks for giving us some of your time.
Thank you.
You're coming to the Mahaffey Theater.
Yep, sure am.
January 13th?
13th, baby. Yep, we're playing at Mahaffey. This is our second time there. We were there last year, and it was really, really incredible. It was so full. But this year, it's going to be sold out.
Yeah, there's not many tickets left. So if you haven't gotten them now, make sure you get them. So so tell me, Rus, how did you get involved with the whole Elton John show?
It kind of fell into place all by itself, to be honest with you. I moved over here from Scotland back in 2003. And I was doing piano bars and, you know, playing keyboards at little tiki bars and things like that. I was a student at the time, so I kind of realized quickly, well, you know, people kind of like this whole, you know, entertainment thing here in America, in Florida, right? Something which you can't really do where I'm from, because it's always cold and rainy and people just want to sit in bars and listen to grunge bands, right? So I was doing these piano bars and I was playing, you know, a lot of songs which I knew, being a keyboard player from I was a little boy. And every time I did an Elton John song, people were kind of going, wow, that was really good. You kind of remind us of Elton John. And I remember going, Elton John, you know, isn't he like maybe 60? And I'm, at the time I was in my 20s. Yeah, no. Elton John from, you know, back
the old
in the
Elton
70s
John.
And the 80s, right? I thought, oh, yeah, I can see it now. So then I started researching, you know, Elton from the 70s and 80s. And YouTube was brand new at the time. Started looking at old clips of him. And my wife and I decided, what would happen if we put a show together that had costumes?
Right.
You just did Elton John for a couple of hours.
Right.
And, well, we did that down on Indian Rocks Beach at a little restaurant called My Place Lounge, right? And this was 2009, and it sold out. And then we put another one on the following week, and it sold out too. And then, of course, newspapers and agents started calling, I guess, and it just kind of got bigger and bigger. And now we're 2023 now. I've got a band, and we're playing all over the country and looking to go international now. We have some international stuff booked.
Wow.
I do stuff with Elton John for his publicity, for his farewell tour and various other things. And it's just, I can't believe how big it's gotten, honestly. But Mahaffey is, I mean, that is the top.
Yeah, you know, it's a beautiful theater. And the sound is really nice in there, too.
Oh, yeah. It's world class. Elton John himself would be privileged to play venues like that.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. So so tell us, you did the you did some work with Elton John for, what was it, the Young Body Double?
Sure. Yeah. We were at a show up in Atlantic City, 2017. And I tell people the story in the show. It's so funny. I got contacted by Elton's office, his lawyer, right? And I went, oh, no. I said, oh, no.
It's over. It's over. My run's over.
Oh, that's it, guys. Sorry. Back to the roofing job on Monday, right? And so I called the guy back, and they were like, we want to use you for some footage that we want to reenact of Elton's 1975 Dodger Stadium concert and various other things. Would you be up for it? So, of course, I was like, what did I do?
Yeah.
So they flew me out to LA, and we shot a whole bunch of amazing videos in virtual reality and 3D, and using today's technology, reenacting moments from his career. And they ended up using that for a lot of his farewell Yellow Brick Road World Tour promotions and publicity. And the launch video was in virtual reality, which you can go online and look at. Just look at Elton John Farewell Yellow Brick Road Tour VR, right? Which is, I guess, how they say virtual reality.
Yeah, yeah.
Back in the 80s, we would say virtual reality.
Right, yeah, now it's just VR.
I'm aging us now, Bill.
Yeah.
But, you know, they contact me for various things now and again. Most recently, they created an Elton John video game on a platform called Roblox, which is for kids. If you've got kids, I'm sure you know what Roblox is. And I'm Elton John in his official Roblox game now, which is really cool. So, yeah, but that's my side gig, Bill. My main gig is with my own band, my own show, doing the full-on live 1970s Elton John experience at places like Mahaffey.
Right. So tell us about the costumes. We were talking about the costumes,
sure.
And you said that your wife is an integral part in the costumes.
Mm-hmm. My wife is who said, why don't we do an Elton John show back in 2009? And from that point on, she's now my road manager. She is my costume designer. She sings in the band. She does everything business-wise and also does everything creative-wise. So from everything to everything from the stage props, the piano, what the band are wearing, what I'm wearing, what she's wearing, what the lighting schematics are, what the set list is, all that stuff is my wife. Her name is Somali, Somali Rose. And we've been together since I moved to America in 2003. So it's been a while, like, you know.
Nice.
It's good a family business, Bill, you know. We are so excited to do it together. It's every day is a challenge, every day is an adventure.
Right.
And of course, Somali is who made the costumes which were used in Elton's farewell tour promotions. Wow. And stuff. So that's the Dodgers costume and his 1970 troubadour outfit for his first ever gig in America back in 1970. So not only does she do the stuff for the live show, she does it for a lot of Elton's media as well.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot of work. And it all comes together because everyone knows in show business there's so much work that goes on before that curtain rises. But once the curtain rises and the audience are having a good time, mm-hmm. it all goes away and everything, no matter what it was, it's all worth it.
It is. It's 90% is offstage, definitely. Definitely, right. Yeah.
So how have you got to meet Elton John?
Sure, yeah.
How is he?
It was so nice to meet. I was terrified, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm sitting there and it was like it was nothing. I mean, I'm sitting kind of like we are now. Mm-hmm. And in comes walking Elton John and his husband, David Furnish, who's his manager and CEO of Rocket, right? They came in and I got to meet him, them, and I got to meet his whole office, his children. We did some photo shoots together, did some videos together. We sat at the lunch table together out in David LaChapelle's studio, very famous photographer out in Los Angeles. And he was so nice to me. And he was very interested in the concept of, you know, an Elton John tribute show. He was like, you know, how you doing? And they were very interested in, you know, so you wear costumes and you kind of reenact stuff. And yep, we do. And I think they were very interested in it. And I know that they got a kick out of it. They really enjoyed what I do. They enjoy people who are creative. And
Right.
And I think more than anything, though, they're just very, very happy that we are out there bringing a smile to people's faces, because when we play at our shows, people are so happy.
Yeah.
I mean, you see people there that are in their 90s, they're 100 years old, and then there's kids there who are, you know, the teenagers.
Absolutely.
And below. And every one of them is just smiling and having a great time. And I think that his office really appreciates that more than anything else. But what a surreal experience meeting Elton. Let me tell you, surreal.
That would be incredible. That would really be incredible. Mm-hmm. So all right, what we're going to do now is we're going to take a look at one of your performances.
Sure.
From the Rocket Man show. Mm-hmm. And then we'll be back in after a couple commercials.
Going to lie, should have stayed on the farm, should have listened to my own mind. No, you can't hold me forever inside up with you. Not a present for your friends to hold, this boy's too young to be singing the blues. Society how you can't cut me in your pantown, going back to my plow, back to you. I don't know what I'm not in that town. Oh, my family side and my future life beyond. Oh, Do you think you're too late to shut down your plane? It'll take you a couple of afternoon time to set you on your feet again. Baby, you got a replacement. There's plenty like me to be found. Among crowds who ain't got one penny, Smith and Fat Davis like you on the ground.
This segment of Tampa Bay Nightlife TV brought to you by
The Corner Bar and Grill in Largo is not just a karaoke bar, it's the karaoke bar in Tampa Bay.
Take my house, take my car, but you can't take my seat at the corner bar.
I don't need this menu, no I don't. I already know just what I want.
I love this bar.
And keeping your safety in mind, the entire corner bar is Cintas certified, electrostatic disinfected regularly, and all microphones are UV cleaned in between singers.
Science.
So come on into the corner bar, 2116 East Bay Drive in Largo, serving up good food, great times, and karaoke 7 nights a week.
Every week at OCC Roadhouse Museum.
Wednesday is live band country line dancing with free lessons from 6 to 7:30 p.m. and dancing all night.
Bring your truck, because it's also Tampa Bay's largest truck night. Every Thursday, we host the largest bike night in Florida with over $1,000 in prizes, live bands, burnouts, stunt shows, and more. Weekends are for regional bands and a huge lineup of national recording artists. Get all the info on upcoming bands, tickets, and free concerts at RoadhouseNation.com.
Two Buck Saloon in Clearwater is a neighborhood sports bar featuring fantastic food, ice-cold beer, and delicious cocktails, all served to you by our friendly staff. We feature karaoke on Friday nights, great live music on Saturday night. Plus, we have the NFL package on 18 TVs on Sundays, Mondays, and Thursdays. We also have two pool tables and golden tea. Tuesday night is trivia. Wednesday night, we have darts. And for you smokers, an all-new covered patio bar. So come check out Two Buck Saloon in Clearwater, 1915 Hercules Avenue, corner of Sunset Point Road. TwoBucks.com has all the information.
Hey, this is Tom Arnold, and you're watching TampaBayNightlife.tv.
So welcome back. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. What a great job you do. And the costumes are out of this world.
Yeah, they're spectacular.
How are they to play in?
It's not easy. I'll tell you that.
Right? I bet.
Not easy. So you've got ostrich feathers, you've got satin, you've got heavy, heavy sequins, and the boots. The boots I've got are 7 inches, and they're so heavy. It's almost like being in a fireman's jumpsuit sometimes.
Wow. You know,
it's just an unbearable weight and heat. Under the stage lights with those big feathers. I don't know how he did it back in the 70s.
Yeah.
Before there was LEDs.
Before the LEDs, right. When there was real heat coming off those lights.
That's next level tolerance. I don't know how he did it. But they look amazing. And of course, you have to make the costumes exact, because when you walk out on stage, before you even hit a note on the piano or sing a note, the people have to be blown away. They're like, wow. If you've seen Elton, it takes you right back. And if you haven't seen Elton, you now know what Elton was all about.
Right.
His costumes were such a huge thing back in the day. Yeah, him, David Bowie, a few of the others, that was part of the whole experience. So we really like to make them exact. My wife Molly sources all the materials. She sources all the photos, all the videos, all the reference materials that you need to make.
Wow.
We zero in on specific concerts, specific years, specific tours, and we make our favorite ones from that bunch. And that's how the shows, the costumes happen in our show.
Wow. So if someone coming to your show, what is the experience like? I mean, I guess, I think we pretty much know what it's like, but what can they expect when they come in?
Well, it really, really is like being at an Elton John concert in the 70s. We don't specifically do like a 1970 or 71, 72. I would say it's a mixture of his kind of most iconic moments and performances and costumes from, I would say, 73 to 76. That's what we focus on. And occasionally we'll dive into, you know, the 80s with the tuxedo and things like that, uh-huh, because you've got some killer songs,
right,
there.
Yeah.
I'm Still Standing and so on. But most of the stuff we do is being at an Elton concert circa 73 to 76 and
nice.
Everything in between. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. How many costume changes? Now, if you don't want to give up the number, how many costume changes are there?
During each show, you know, could be 5, could be 10. You never know. It's going to be several, though, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I have to get out of them quickly because I get
I bet.
So, but we've got a couple of really special things planned for Mahaffey that we haven't done before.
Ooh,
and
nice.
Haven't done in a while elsewhere. So for the band, we're excited. We're going to get to try out some new stuff. We're going to do a night of greatest hits and some greatest costumes too. So,
wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's going to be epic.
That is awesome. Mm-hmm. That is awesome.
Mm-hmm. We have a full band too. There's going to be 6 of us. So.
Right. So, and if you want tickets to the show, it's at the Mahaffey, January 13th. You got to go to themahaffey.com. Mm-hmm. And get them fast, because the last time we looked, there weren't very many left.
No, they're almost gone now.
Yeah, they're almost gone, mm-hmm. And they will be gone.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you.
So tell me, Russ, tell me about some of the highlights of your career doing this as Elton.
As Elton? Well, it's been just a crazy freight train since the start. I mean, we started off in a little restaurant, just me and the piano. Then it was me and the piano and tracks. And then started to, well, you kind of need a band, right? So that evolved. Getting to play some of the bigger venues was a kind of eye-opener, because I'm going, well, we're no longer in this kind of beach bar level that
I've been
doing for years.
Right.
It was then I realized how big it was getting, but the definitive moment was definitely not even getting to meet Elton. I think what was bigger for me was the phone call I got, the first phone call from his office. That's an unbeatable moment for me. But since then, excuse me, I've been involved in so many cool things with so many other tribute artists,
uh-huh,
and so many other collaborators. I was on a wonderful TV show on E! Last year called Clash of the Cover Bands, which had Adam Lambert and Meghan Trainor and a whole bunch of other tribute acts.
Wow.
I was featured on that, and I was the season finale. So they went with Elton John for the season finale, and on that episode, it was a rap battle type of thing between me and a friend of mine who is a Lady Gaga tribute artist. So it was
nice.
Really cool. It was right before Christmas. It's called Clash of the Cover Bands, and That was a huge highlight, you know, because that was network TV.
Yeah, that's E. Yeah, E. That's worldwide.
Wow. Since then, the doors are just opening in all kinds of directions. We are grateful to be on stage and performing again. We love seeing the audience's faces.
It's
my job when I go out there. I want every single person in that audience to feel like they're part of an experience. And they're all laughing. They're singing along. They know all the songs. They know every word. And they know Elton John. They know his character. Yep. They know his costume. So what I do is I just try and recreate that magic for another day, you know. And if they want to go and see Elton, he's still touring. But if they want to see Elton in the 70s, wow, they have to come and see the Rocketman show.
They have to come see the Congratulations. I'm really, really, really happy for you. And as an Elton John fan myself, I mean, it's a great thing to know that even though he's not going to be moving on, mm-hmm. you know, with more tours, you'll still be out there, and you take such pride in making it right and doing it right. You're not just out there just to, hey, I kind of look like him and I can play the piano, or mm-hmm. you know, and that's really nice to know, and I'm sure everyone's going to greatly appreciate it.
Thank you, Bill. Yeah, I love it. I really love what I do. I've always loved Elton John's music. I don't think I look like him. I don't know.
Well, no, I wouldn't say look like. I guess when you put the costumes on.
Do you think so?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's a resemblance for sure. How's that?
Yeah, I think that Elton has such a unique, it's a unique essence.
Right.
And I think I do know that his office did like that. That I wasn't an impersonator, but I just was capturing the essence of Elton, and I think that's what I strive to do, because no one can be Elton. And in fact, no one can be any of the tribute acts, whether it's Elvis or Michael Jackson or Lady Gaga, but in their own right, there's some talent out there. And I think if you capture the essence of that artist, then it's definitely a standalone show. And I think Elton's office appreciated that, you know, I'm not pretending to be Elton.
Right, exactly. You're paying tribute to him.
Yeah,
you're paying homage to him.
Yeah, sure,
yeah. Yep. And what did the first phone call... What did they say? I mean, it was like...
My blood pressure's gone up. Thank them, Bill.
I bet.
The day I got the call, we were about to go on stage in Atlantic City at Harrah's Casino, of all places, which was such a great venue. But I got the call, and I said to my wife, what should I do? And she says, well, you have to call the guy back. You can't ignore it, right?
Right, yeah.
There's no way I can go on stage with this hanging over, right? And when I called him back, what a relief, but what an honour. I remember she caught the moment on film with her cell phone. I just, when they told me what it was about, and I burst into tears, especially when I knew that it was Elton himself who had picked me to play him for some of his farewell tour media. So that moment was crazy. I don't think I'll ever get over that. I'm excited about making this, you know, like expanding this and onward and upward, and we are ready to start some major touring.
Oh, how great is that?
Yeah,
how great is
starting at Mahaffey.
There you go. Yeah. There you go. Russ, thank you for your time.
Thank you, Bill.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
January 13th, the Mahaffey Theater. Get your tickets if there's any available. You do not want to miss it. Thanks for giving us some of your time. Absolutely love it. Russ Anderson, The Rocket Man Show.
Thanks again, man.
Brother.
Thank you.
Maybe we'll see you around town sometime, too.
Sure, I'll be around.
Down Indian Rocks Beach?
Yeah, I'll be at Indian Rocks Beach.
There we go.
I'm Gabby.
I'm Ashley.
And I'm Cassie. And we're from Clearwater Beach Hooters.
And you're watching Tampa Bay Nightlife.tv.
Make sure you follow Tampa Bay Nightlife TV on all the social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.
Well, that's going to do it for this week's show. Thanks for tuning in. Please follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and on YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel because, well, we show things on YouTube that we just can't show on TV. And on that note, please, everyone, be safe. And don't forget to get up, get out, and live it up.